This is Lenny Farley, Purdue University Extension Forester. Now let's ID that tree. On this edition of ID That Tree, we're going to introduce you to another of our common Indiana oaks, and this is black oak. Black oak's oftentimes found on dry upland sites, although we can find it in some other locations as well. As in all the oaks, black oak has alternate leaf arrangement, and with the red and black group, it has lobes with bristle tips on the ends of the lobes. Black oak also tends to have very deeply cut sinuses, the spaces between the lobes, that approach the midrib of the leaf. And also, it oftentimes has a shiny surface on the top of the leaf, shinier than what we find in northern red oak. One of the best identification characteristics on the twigs for black oak are these angular, yellowish, fuzzy buds. Very large, light tan, as compared to northern red oak, which is smooth and dark red to brown. Smooth stems, as we mentioned, alternate leaf arrangement. The bark on black oak has a tendency to be very dark, thus the name, and also relatively blocky, and lacks the silvery running ridges up and down the trunk like what we see on northern red oak. Black oak can also be identified in the fall with the acorns. So we're lucky to find a few acorns the squirrels haven't consumed. And you'll notice kind of small rounded acorns with striping running up and down the sides of the acorn and kind of a fuzzy coating on the outside edge. The caps, in addition, deeper than northern red oak, and on the outside edge scales, they tend to be kind of loose, like loose shingles on the very edge of the cap, giving a much rougher appearance than what we find on that shallow and tight-scaled northern red oak cap.